I got on my knees and begged you not to leave because I go berserk. Well, you left me anyhow, and then the days got worse and worse, and now you see I've gone completely out of my mind.
Yay, hey, we've all gone completely out of our mind, and one of the reasons is because we've got creepy crawlies hanging around here again today, because we've been joined by the fabulous Burt Canduccio from the Victorian Insectarium. Welcome, Burt.
Hi.
Good. How are you?
Really good, mate. Good. How are you?
Good. A bit hungry. You feeling a bit peckish?
Well, what
I thought we'd do today for something a little bit different is talk a little bit about insects in diets of various peoples around the world. So I bought a couple of things to have a look at. Now, first of all, we've all eaten these things before, haven't we? And just think about, before you actually peel a prawn, you need to remove the external shell. Mm-hmm. You have to shell the prawn, and also same for crayfish, crustaceans, etc. Well, these animals that we've got are virtually exactly the same. Now, if I can get the camera to come up close, have a look at this. This is a cast shell of this particular tarantula. Now, she needs to molt every now and then in order to grow. No? So if you think of a spider as a hairy-looking cousin of a prawn, we're halfway there into tasting these wonderful culinary delights that I've brought along. No? I've got, if you come over here, have a close look, what I've prepared while you were on for the last segment is I've actually brought along some mealworms. Now, a lot of people confuse these with worms, but they're not. They're actually an immature type of beetle. And what we've done is we've baked them in the oven. First we cleaned them and washed them. Then we've baked them in the oven. And so now they're ready to try. Now, what you do is pick one up and just pop it in your mouth and have a bit of a chew, and it's very, very similar to prawn crackers. Now, in Africa, at certain times of the year, there's a very close relative of this guy that actually covers lakes, and the women go out, gather them up, and make them into a type of cake, and they call them kunga cake, and it's quite a delicacy over there too. But unfortunately, we're going to have to make do with this, because this is the closest we can get to the African dish.
Okay.
So pass it around.
For Tabatha, I believe that you would like to eat one of these little immature bugs here.
Yes, Tabatha, give her a hand. Yes, well done.
Let's have. Mm-hmm. And we've also got our next guest coming up is Sue, come in through. Susan Harbin from the Pride Awards is going to come in, and she's going to eat a... Tabatha, don't be greedy.
You're not.
Oh, Susan, have one of those as well.
I'm dying to.
They are nice.
Are they
similar to pork crackers?
Are they?
Yeah, they are nice.
Troy, are you going to have one?
I'm vegetarian.
What about you, my mum?
While you guys are having a go at that, I'm going to get ready to make a special salad. So I'm going to prepare a special salad.
Oh my God.
So, yeah, well done. Give him a hand. Well done. Yes. Good.
Some drag kings, and I must warn those viewers that are underage or any of the gay boys that find, you know, women's parts, you know, not something that they want to look at, there is a flash gash warning being issued for this piece of footage. So if you don't want to see women's genitalia, and all the lesbians that run to a monitor, turn away. Okay, let's go for that.
Come on, it's great.
Thank you.
weren't you, Dan?
I was holding the camera.
You were holding the camera, and you were very still, very concentrated camera work.
Yeah, did you notice? Like, when the money shot was on, I still had it steady, but there's a few of those at night.
Yeah.
It was actually a fantastic night. It was the Drag Kings final.
Raving reporter, Love Kitten, and I have really, really lucked out this time. I'm standing here with Graham. I'd love you to pan down and have a look at this. My God. Very hurt. Very nice. Very toned. Very tan. Graham,
yeah.
How long has it taken you to get a body like this?
Well, I'm 45 years old, so...
Jesus! He's 45! Yeah. You're doing very, very well.
Thank you.
How long does it take you to, like, build up this thing?
It's been a part of my lifestyle, really, for about 20 years.
So, like, how many times a week do you have to do the gym?
I only got two or three now.
And, like, how many hours each time?
40 minutes to an hour, that's it.
Have you got any advice for any, like, young queens out there that, like, have got skinny little rake bodies built like a broomstick that want to, like, one day look like this?
Yeah.
How would you tell them to go about it? Like, how is, like, reality?
I suppose, really, if you really want something hard enough, you'll do it.
It's true, like anything.
Yeah.
You know, like, well, you just signed up, like, when did you start training?
About 20 years ago.
And, like, when you first started training, how many hours a week did you do?
About an hour and a half. About six.
I mean, that's not that much of a commitment, really, when you think about it, is it?
Well, you've got to make time. Everyone has a lot of unhealthy sort of things they do in life. You've got to have a few healthy things.
Yeah, like smoking and drinking.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, look, Graham, it's been an absolute pleasure talking to you. I just want to ask you one thing before we go back to the studio. Do you like boys or girls?
Well, let's see. I try not to differentiate.
Sorry?
I try not to differentiate and don't like really gender. I just go for the person.
Okay, so that means boys are on the cards then.
Absolutely.
Well, I think we should go back to the studio because I'm busy. Bye.
Hey. The price you girls pay for beauty, I tell ya, I don't know so much. I've had my eyebrows done once, and I just, that thing, when queens pluck their eyebrows and it's too short,
it's very
just
obvious.
Looks really queeny, but it wasn't too bad because I told her that I liked the Brooke Shields look, but it was the pink for the day and a half that I couldn't deal with.
Like wearing eye makeup.
Pink eyeshadow, I couldn't deal with it at all, and as you can see by you, they're actually not too bad then.
They're not. They're coming out very good.
Let's keep the crown jewels covered if we can.
Okay, do you want to pull, Paul?
Oh, no.
No, go on, you do it. I think that we need a... Okay, and how long have you been doing these sorts of treatments?
The third day.
I've been doing it for about 20 years.
20 years?
Yep.
And you've just about had enough, haven't you?
I had stopped until... there's... Steve decided to get me back into the show.
There's really only so much pubic hair you can rip off bodies before you get sick of it, really, isn't there? What's your most grotesque job that you've done? I think that's probably a good one.
Grotesque job?
Yeah.
My very first works.
Yeah.
Was in a city salon. Keep your legs down.
I'm talking for one.
No, that's okay. Keep your legs down. We'll continue.
Come on, go. Get
was in a city
get it
salon.
Open, done with. Yep.
And I had a lady come in. And mind you, this was my first wax. So she wanted her bikini line shaped in a love heart.
Oh, romantic.
And I was very, I can't remember, but I just remember being very nervous about it.
So I call that pubic hairdressing. And there's a salon in Amsterdam that specialises in that. I can remember seeing something on SBS. I'm going to go back and join that rest of the panel.
Sure you don't want to pull off one more streak?
No.
No?
I don't think that Tabatha and I need to... share that sort of experience with each other. I much prefer to have fun talking with Tabatha than causing her pain.
Ready? Next one.
Focus.
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 Yay,
focus.
Focus
on focus. Rolling credits.
We will need absolute silence in the studio during the mug shot so that we can get the sound effect.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So, colour of the rainbow drinks.
About
We have a humongous show. You would have seen just in that little opening snippet there that I'm have been joined at the table not only by my regular guest, my regular panelist, that whole tea thing happening again this week, but also, we'll take a wide shot now, you can see that we have three cast members from the television show Prisoner. Hi,
Mike.
Hi, Mike.